Alrighty, folks, welcome back to the show. You know, the holidays are right around the corner, and what better gift to give than something that's handmade, a little bit more personal, and a lot more beautiful. So we are here with a woman that just might fit your needs. We are here with Andrea, who's a lapidarian. I'm gonna pronounce that all day and never get it right. I'm glad you helped me out with that. And she's also a silversmith who pretty much makes all the wonderful, wonderful items and jewelry that are displayed here on the table. Welcome to the show.
Hi. No, maybe. I mean, a lapidarian. I mean, did I pronounce it right?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Well, so she gets it right, but I can't.
Maybe just give us the definition of what that
so
means.
So lapidary is the art of just cutting stones.
Mm-hmm.
Not gemology, but mm-hmm. lapidary. So I just take, like, this malachite, and I'll take it to a saw, and then I'll cut it down, polish it, and eventually it'll turn out something like this.
Eventually, just super easy.
A couple hours later, a little bit of patience, you know, here it is.
Now, how did you get involved with that? Were you taking classes? I mean, how do you?
Well, ever since I was a kid, I've always loved rocks. My life pretty much revolves around rocks. I rock climb, I teach yoga for rock climbers, I hunt rocks, I cut them, I shape them, I polish them. Kind of a rock nerd. So,
I like that you hunt rocks. Are they running away from you?
How does that work? They very slowly.
Very slowly. Yeah. They hide among the leaves.
Yeah. I'm part of a gem and mineral society out of Yucaipa,
mm-hmm.
so they have a wonderful studio, lots of equipment, really awesome people.
Mm-hmm. Now, are any of these stones from Yucaipa?
Yes, actually. These two are from, this is an agate from Yucaipa. One of the members of the club found it in their yard.
Just in their yard.
In their yard.
Hanging out.
I was like, that's amazing. You never know mm-hmm. what you have. Like,
the colors are stunning.
Stunning. Reds, yeah. Greens, blues. It's amazing. I mean, you walk by a rock and you just think, oh, it's some rock.
Right.
You cut it open, you never know. I mean, boulder opal.
There's some life lessons there.
Stuff in Australia, but not here. But, you know.
How long did it take you to get, you know, the skill that you have now? How long did it take for you to
really? I was a natural.
Oh, right.
I'm sure.
So nonchalant about
it. Actually, this was my very first piece I ever cut.
Really?
So I'm obviously never going to get rid of that. This one has sentimental value mm-hmm. to me.
Of course. I'll give you $5 for it.
$5.
Right now. Cash.
Talk to me after the show.
All right. We'll talk later.
So you learned the skill, and then you just gradually started selling them as well, right?
Yeah. I had a lot of people asking me for them. I was good friends with a tattoo artist named Devin Mena, and he has gauges. So he's like, Dre, why don't you make gauges? Mm-hmm. And I was like, okay. And that was... It's so tedious to make the gauges. That's probably the most tedious thing out of all of it. I mean, it takes 5 hours with the equipment that I have available to me. There's mm-hmm. other equipment that you can have that'll cut these grooves in it a lot easier, but what I have, it takes me a long time.
So that's cool, though, because you can definitely do some, I mean, Daniel's mentioning the holidays, and you can do some custom pieces.
Yeah.
But there would definitely be, there's a lot of value there, mm-hmm. clearly, for the time and the product that you make.
Yeah.
Where do you sell your items?
I have an Instagram account, which I sell more off of that than on my Etsy account. Honestly, that's mm-hmm. like a trend. It's happening more and more.
Right.
So my Etsy is actually, I have Megalithic Stoneworks and I have Le Sphinx 777. And both of those, you can get a link to my Etsy account at the top, which is, you can also go online, megalithicstoneworks.com, and that'll just go straight to my Etsy account mm-hmm. instead of all that slash garbage with the Etsy shops. I don't like all that.
Yeah.
Who does, right?
Who does, yeah.
So you have pictures of all your products on there?
I do.
And then if people can bring you a stone maybe and say, hey, you know what, I want to make this into like a really cool
I have had people
piece,
do that.
Right?
Yes.
Excellent. Excellent.
Now you mentioned you've been doing it ever since you were little, right?
I was little, I was interested in it, but I've been actually cutting for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Wow, only 2 years and already you have these amazing pieces.
Yeah.
All right, excellent. Well, I know Betsy for sure is going to ask you for one of these amazing pieces. I mean, you know, mm-hmm. but I was wondering if maybe you could do us like a special thing, like for Inland Empire Live. Can you make a whole like list, like Inland Empire Live out of like one piece of rock? Is that doable?
I mean, I can etch into
Or maybe
stone.
Just IEA. If you can make me an IEA ring. That would be really cool.
I could do with the silver would be a lot easier, and then I could put gems or stones
that's perfect.
Yeah, see, she's already thinking about it. It's like
very custom work.
Yeah, it's maybe like a triple finger ring. Like,
yeah, That would
now,
be bad.
Actually, one of these, you're turning it into a double finger ring, right?
Oh, yeah. This one right here, it's just absolutely ridiculous.
Oh, ridiculously awesome.
Yeah,
so cool.
Okay, so this is crazy lace agate. It's a little bit more of an expensive, a little bit more rare agate. It's beautiful.
Where did you find it?
It was given to me by one of the members, and I was like, oh, thank you.
Yeah.
That's awesome. So it's going to be set in here, and then just...
That
absolutely
is so
ridiculous.
Cool. Just like beautiful. Such like a one of a kind piece.
Yeah, statement jewelry. Mm-hmm. I'm all about it.
Sure. Yeah. Right? Yes. Nobody else can order that.
What is it that you enjoy about like this stone cutting and silversmithing
it's
so much?
It's so meditative. Mm-hmm. I love it. I mean, some people even use the stones for meditation purposes. Mm-hmm. Like this is called a palm stone. You can sit there, and a lot of the people believe that stones have healing powers, different mm-hmm. things. Each stone correlates to different parts of the body, all kinds of different things. So some people order these things with the intention of having healing powers or whatever. So that's really cool, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very cool. Well, I'm glad you were on the show. We're definitely giving people some really great holiday ideas, and not even just holiday ideas, just everyday things that you can wear that, like I said, are unique, one of a kind, obviously made by someone who's from the Inland Empire. Also
local,
a really cool
local.
Thing.
Yay.
Very
absolutely
cool.
Local. Thank you so much. If you can give your website and your Instagram one more time so we can send our viewers to you.
I have listing 777 at Instagram. I also have Megalithic Stoneworks on Instagram. Megalithicstoneworks.com. If you just type that in, it's going to go straight to my Etsy account. So.
Perfect.
Andrea, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Absolutely, reach out to her, check out the website, go hunting for some of those rocks. I love it. We'll be right back, everyone.
You know what, Betsy? I thought so, too. Thank you, folks, for tuning in to another episode of Inland Empire Live. We hope to see you again. Bye-bye.
We should both be on our phones. Like, no. Oh, hey, guys, we're going to do another show.
We'll put a selfie on there. Do you want to do that? I mean, like this. Like, let's get started.
When we sit down?